the story of the DH98, or Mosquito, is one of brilliant success. The design, which wasn't started till after the war began, is in the tradition of the Albatross and the Comet, and its makers rightly take great pride in the fact that flight trials began only 11 months after the start of design work. Its construction of wood has three principal advantages: speed through design and prototype stages into production, the use of new material supplies, and the employment of a fresh labor group. Natural buoyancy is another point. Mosquitoes have floated in water for many hours. The stressed skin fuselage, proved by the Albatross in 1937, has been proved again by the Mosquito. While I wouldn't like to say that anybody could build a Mosquito, its construction is very widely dispersed. Many furniture and other woodworking factories, large and small, have been turned over to the job. If it's to be furniture or mosquitoes, Britain, for the time being, prefers mosquitoes. 22 months after the start of design, the Mosquito was in action against the enemy. A test pilot, designers, and Captain de Havilland are seen standing beside one of these magnificent aircraft, at the moment the fastest aircraft in operation in the world. Everyone knows many of the feats already accomplished by those machines, over enemy-occupied territory, over Germany, over Berlin in daylight. In point of fact, the Mosquito was originally conceived as a bomber that would be faster than contemporary fighters. The fighter version was a development. Anyway, as a bomber, it carries 2,000 pounds of bombs with a range that takes in almost the whole of Germany. Well, that's the Mosquito. Intruder, long-range day fighter, day and night bomber, and how it flies, even with one of its Rolls-Royce Merlins out of action. Mosquito has certainly gone far to prove that British designers and Royal Air Force pilots will continue to make rings round the enemy till the war is won. A Toronto factory adds to the Mosquito strength of the Royal Air Force. The famous Mosquito, which is made of specially constructed plywood, has already proved itself in two capacities. As a bomber, in operations as daring and as distant as the daylight raid on Berlin, as a fighter, by such outstanding action as the shooting down of German bombers in the Bay of Biscay. One of the most successful types of modern warplanes, these fighter bombers have a big role to play in operations yet to come. The Allies need plenty of them, and Canada's doing her bit to produce Mosquitoes in large numbers. On the 5th of December, 34 Mosquitoes of Coastal Command flew off on a particularly difficult operation. A number of German merchant ships and their escorts were known to be lying in Nordgulen Fjord, Norway, and to attack them meant diving steeply between the snow-capped mountains of the enemy's hideout. They were pretty certain to have to face heavy flak in addition. RAF film shows how they did the job. Diving from 5,000 feet at over 300 miles an hour, they fairly let them have it with cannon shells and rockets. You can clearly see tracers and rockets hitting the ships and gun flashes from the ships. spite of the extraordinary difficulties of the position in which the ships were lying, in spite of everything they could put up in the way of flak, the Mosquitoes pressed home their attack with the utmost daring and success. Every ship was left burning.
Far away, and won't you please say hello?